I'm Dr. Michael Amendola. I'm a vascular surgeon, general and vascular surgeon here at the Central Virginia VA Healthcare System. And I'm the senior innovation fellow for the VA as well, dealing with 3D printing. 3D printing is what we call an additive manufacturing. We're used to traditionally subtractive manufacturing. So for example, if you take an axe, okay, you have a handle, which is made of wood, you cut down a tree, you take that, you whittle that down to the handle, so you're subtracting to the handle. 3D printing allows you to build from the base materials up to what you want. It allows you to print out what you need almost literally as you need it. And so the application of this technology in VA is in a lot of different areas. So there's the what I call the big five in 3D printing in VA. So dental applications, assistive or adaptive technologies, orthotics and prosthetics, audiology, and then pre-surgical planning.
There are a whole lot of different types of 3D printers. Some produce just out of plastic, like ABS plastic, which is like Lego type of material. And it shoots out kind of like icing on a cake, you know, layer by layer. But then you also have ones that are resin based. And so the way that they come out is with a resin type of material. It's a softer, clearer type of material. And it comes out from the bottom from this resin base. And then you also have ones that are very specific to pre-surgical planning and medical modeling. And it can produce different types of material all at the same time. So if you want to simulate bone, with tissue, with muscle, you can really feel after it prints the different textures as if they're really touching the human being. And so you really want that as a surgeon. So if you're pre-surgically planning what is going to happen, they can see where everything is and really feel it and decide how surgery is going to occur.
Medical modeling starts with a clinician, typically a surgeon, has some sort of problem they want to solve. They typically have medical imaging in the form of CT or MRI. Basically, it's a stack of images. So if you take a piece of anatomy, say a skull, slice it into a bunch of layers, all of those layers form the CT or the MRI. We take that into a segmentation software and then basically pick out in each of those images, what's, say, bone in this case, what's the bone of the skull, or what's the part of a tumor. Once all of those stacks of images have been kind of masked for different anatomy, we can produce a 3D model.
One of the value of 3D printing is we're able to pull it apart and show different aspects of the anatomy from within. This is great for pre-surgical planning, so what we do as surgeons, but also when we teach surgery, to teach trainees to say, okay, this approach to the spine, for example, here might be different because you might have an outpouching here that needs to be dealt with. We're doing this translation all the time as surgeons. We're constantly doing this because we think in 2D space, traditional medical imaging, and then we also think in 3D space because we operate in 3D space. We solve problems in three-dimensional space. So that's why 3D modeling is a pretty important tool for us as surgery. It's part of what we need to teach the next generation of surgeons. It's what we will be teaching them, and we're going to lead in terms of that in VA.